The world was shocked to learn that Michael Jackson suddenly died in 2009. How did his ex-wife Lisa Marie Presley find out? And did she have a sense it happened before she got the news? Lisa Marie Presley and Michael Jackson sent shockwaves throughout the world when they announced they tied the knot in 1994. The news of their marriage came just days after Lisa Marie divorced influential Scientologist Danny Keough, as the Washington Post noted at the time. According to Us Weekly, Jackson befriended Presley amid the accusations that the King of Pop had sexually assaulted 13-year-old Jordan Chandler in 1993, which Jackson denied.
"I am totally innocent of any wrongdoing."
They often talked on the phone, and it was by phone that Jackson reportedly proposed to Presley, who was still married to Keough. Presley revealed in a statement at the time, "I am very much in love with Michael. I dedicate my life to being his wife." The marriage didn't last. By December 1995, the couple was separated, with Presley filing for divorce in January 1996, just a year and a half after their wedding. According to Us Weekly, the union was strained partly because of Jackson's painkiller addiction. To this day, many people believe that Jackson and Presley's relationship was just a show, as Radar Online argued in 2019. In a blog post following Jackson's death, republished by Oprah.com, Presley assured that while their relationship was what she called unusual, it had not been a sham.
"I honestly can tell you that it was every sense a normal marriage."
To heal, Presley learned to dissociate from Jackson and her relationship with him. That's why she surprised even herself by how devastated she felt when she heard about her former husband's death. On June 25, 2009, Lisa Marie Presley was in England, as she told Oprah Winfrey in 2010. Even before hearing about Michael Jackson's death, Presley was having a very unusual day. Presley recalled, "I don't know why, but it was the strangest day of my life. I was crying all day, and I don't normally do that." Even though she was living a seemingly normal day, she was unable to carry out simple tasks without being overwhelmed by her emotions. Presley told Oprah, "I was trying to work. I came home. I was literally cutting my food, eating my dinner, crying." As NPR reported at the time, Jackson was pronounced dead at 2:26 p.m. Pacific time, which was already nighttime in the United Kingdom. After eating dinner, Presley felt like calling it a day. Lisa Marie told Oprah, "I wanted to go upstairs and go to bed and watch something mindless on TV and stop crying." As it turned out, her day was just starting. Text messages began rolling in asking if she was okay. The first one of those was from her friend, John Travolta. Confused, she asked him what was happening. So it was actually Travolta who broke the news of Jackson's death to Lisa Marie Presley. In her interview with Oprah, Presley said this about her reaction to Michael Jackson's death. "It was real, honest-to-goodness shock. Not even tears. I was floored, honestly floored." After going many years without speaking to Jackson, she began her healing process, telling Oprah, "This whole last year and a half has been spent trying to gain the clarity." Lisa Marie Presley last spoke with Michael Jackson in 2005, per the Los Angeles Times. According to Presley, the King of Pop asked her if she still loved him. Presley told the newspaper, "I told him I was indifferent. He didn't like that word. He cried." Writing in a June 26, 2009 MySpace post, Presley revealed that she avoided contact with Jackson because she needed to put that chapter behind her. Presley wrote, "All of my indifference and detachment that I worked so hard to achieve over the years has just gone into the bowels of hell, and right now I am gutted." After his death, Presley dedicated time to understanding Jackson's rationale, telling Oprah, "I realized all this bitterness I thought I had was no longer present." To some extent, Presley saw her father's pains reflected in her ex-husband, which she hinted at in her blog post. In a conversation with Jackson when they were still together, Presley recalled, he stated with an almost calm certainty, "I'm afraid that I'm going to end up like your father, the way he did." While Elvis's official cause of death was heart failure, the underlying reasons are widely attributed to his drug use, per PBS. When Jackson died from an overdose of propofol, as CNN reported, Presley wrote feeling like she failed to help him from having the same fate as her father.